Brock Lesnar's actions last week were disgusting, reprehensible, and if I'm being honest, an act of total cowardice. How dare he lay his hands on the heart of this corporate engine? I give every piece of myself to this company, and I will not be disrespected. That cannot, will not happen again. I called Mr. Lesnar earlier today and I informed him over the telephone that due to his actions, in addition to his suspension, I'm hereby fining him the sum of $1 million.
What?
Thank you.
Excuse me, Paul?
Yes?
How do you think Brock Lesnar is going to respond, not only his indefinite suspension, but now this startling $1 million fine?
Amazing, you're still employed. Your timing, as always, is impeccable, Ms. Braxton. I know how the tribal chief, Roman Reigns, would respond to this. Roman Reigns, suspension or not, would show up on SmackDown, would smash everyone in sight, including and especially Brock Lesnar. But Roman Reigns doesn't have to do that, because Roman Reigns smashed Brock Lesnar at Crown Jewel.
Okay, but again, how would Brock Lesnar respond?
How would Brock Lesnar respond?
Look, it's not a trick question. You used to advocate for Brock Lesnar, and we're looking for some insight that, Paul, only you can provide. So yes, how would Brock Lesnar respond?
And Brock Lesnar would respond by showing up at the office and ripping out everybody's throat, especially and starting with Adam Pearce. Pearce, what an annoying name for an annoying man. Can you imagine the audacity, the temerity of Adam Pearce to stand in the middle of the ring and talk about Brock Lesnar like Brock Lesnar wasn't even in the arena, like he's not Brock Lesnar, like he's not going to come out and be a beast? Brock Lesnar, like Brock Lesnar. Oh. At least that's how I think Brock Lesnar would respond. I haven't spoken to Brock Lesnar. Leave me alone, will you?
A lot to digest.